Mike Phillips with AutoGeek.com, and I'm here today with Rod Kraft, the sales manager and technical trainer for Griot's Garage. And today, we're going to take a look at the Griot's Garage Random Orbital Polisher. You know, Rod, this is probably the most versatile tool on the market. And the reason it's versatile is because in order to turn it into a different tool, all you've got to do is change the backing plate so you can use a different size pad.
That's correct, Mike. What's unique about this is everybody knows this has what's normally a 6-inch random orbital, but the cool thing is that we can take the normal 6-inch backing plate that would come with this, we can change it to a 5 or a 3, so you have that versatility with multiple size backing plates.
And one of the things I like about this tool is it has a lot of power, okay, and that's important, especially when buffing out curved panels. And that what that power means is you can maintain pad rotation no matter what the pad size. And to me, when I'm buffing out a car, that means I can get the job done faster while maintaining high quality results.
You know, that's exactly right, Mike. The beauty of this is an 850 watt motor, so it delivers just a constant level of torque, so that it's always there when you need it. So the beauty about the pad rotation is that whether it's a 6, a 5, or a 3, for all those larger flat panels, maybe some of the contours and radiuses and all the tight spots, maybe your A pillars and B pillars.
Mm-hmm. And so let's go ahead and let's talk about the tool. Besides having a lifetime warranty, compact size, lightweight, powerful, let's take a look at the different backing plates that are available for this and of course the pads.
So the 6-inch, when you normally get this, if you were to order it just as a normal 6-inch random orbital, it would normally come with a yellow backing plate, standard size, but the beauty is that the two new backing plates, I should say, that we've introduced a little while back is, they have what's called a heat management system. And what's kind of unique about that is it's vented. So not many people are aware that a lot of your heat buildup is actually at the Velcro contact points with your pad and backing plate. So these vented holes allow for air to go through and cool. So you're actually getting a little bit longer pad life and less wear.
Yeah, and that's important because basically what happens when you're polishing with one of these tools, you're applying a little bit of downward pressure. The thing is oscillating and rotating, and with the pressure, the time, and the oscillation action, heat is going to build up. And by having these holes, now it has a place to escape.
That's exactly right.
And that's going to lengthen what's called the adhesive life between the Velcro and the pad itself, so you get more life out of the pad.
That's right.
And I remember in the early days of polishing, that was probably the weakest point in the pads was the adhesive technology. But the problem was the heat buildup. So it looks like Griot's has addressed the primary culprit behind pad failure, and that's the heat buildup.
That's correct. You're absolutely right.
Besides tackling the heat issue with backing plates, what else makes these unique?
Well, you know, what's pretty unique about this is that most people aren't even aware that sometimes just some of the backing plates that you see on the market have just maybe 3 rivets.
Mm-hmm.
So we've actually put 6 on all 3 of these. So you've got much more durability. They're balanced, which gives it a little bit smoother operation. So you're not transitioning all that vibration through the tool. This particular one, the 3-inch, which is nice about this is a very heavy duty backing plate. A lot of the 3-inch that you see on the market are very thin, small, lightweight.
Exactly.
So they're not going to hold up to all that torque that your tool is delivering down to the surface.
Mm-hmm. And the other thing is this Una construction. So it's actually just basically one piece the way this is made. So there's nothing to come apart on.
That's correct. Right.
So Rod, besides the backing plate, let's talk about pad options for these tools.
So Mike, if you notice, there's a number of combinations. We've got 3 tools set up here. We've got one with a 3-inch, a 5-inch, and a 6-inch backing plate. And then there's 6 pads for each particular size. So when you take those 3 different size pads and then the 6 different pads themselves individually, you end up with about 100 or so different combinations. So the versatility is just endless.
And what that means is whatever the pad size which you match to the panel you're buffing out, you can do your basic compounding, polishing, finish polishing if you're working on a show car, even machine waxing.
That's correct.
So there's something for everything just in this combination alone. And what I think is important, especially if you're watching this video and you detail cars for money, instead of buying one tool, which is a great value, buy 3 tools, set them up with each of the different size backing plates, and then you won't be fooling around, wasting time changing backing plates. Just grab the tool that has the right backing plate for the pad, for the panel that you want to buff. And besides speeding things up, your tools will last longer over time anyway because you're not trying to do everything with just one tool.
You're exactly right. You know, in my days when I had my detail business, time is money. So you want to make sure that you're a little bit more efficient with your process. And like you said, if you have 3 separate tools set up for the price point, which is really not that bad,
no,
tools are going to last longer and you're going to save a lot of time.
And if you got a helper, while you're using, say, the 6-inch, they could be using the 3-inch.
Oh, I agree.
Knock out a car even faster.
Exactly right.
Well, you know what? For more information on the Griot's Garage Orbital Polisher, the backing plates and the pads, visit autogeek.com. For more videos like these and how-tos, subscribe to our YouTube channel. So a lot of times when I'm buffing out a car, what I really like is I can grab this tool right here, and for example, this Camaro back here, while there's a lot of large panels, there's a lot of thin panels, and I can get right in there with a 3.5-inch pad and knock it out, and that means the compounding, the polishing, even the machine waxing step.
That's right. You know, the beauty of the 3-inch, which wasn't around back when I had my detail business, is that the versatility, the size, and just the adaptability to all those different contours, radiuses, and recesses.
Yeah, it's really a time saver, but it's also something that enables you to do both production work and show car work. And that is the market.